When you're looking at Y-DNA or mitochondrial DNA, you're assigned a haplogroup. Now, if you share a haplogroup with somebody, how closely related are you? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Today, we're looking at haplogroups. Because Y-DNA and mitochondrial DNA are passed down essentially unchanged, we can use them to classify people based on their paternal or their maternal heritage. After me and my brother-in-law had tested at 23andMe, we found out that we were part of the same haplogroup, R1B1B2A1A, I think. Yay! We're practically related! Or are we really? Well, before we get into that, let's hear about our sponsor. Family Roots Conference is at the end of September in St. George, Utah. This conference has over 80 classes, entertainment for the whole family, and lots of the speakers that you enjoy. So if you want to learn more about your family history, go to the website we list in the description below and register for the Family Roots Conference and stop by and say hi to us. And now back to haplogroups. R1B1B2A1A is not uncommon in Europe. In fact, most Europeans are one of the R1B haplogroups. So even though my ancestry is primarily from England and my brother-in-law's ancestry is primarily from Germany, it's entirely likely that we are from the same haplogroup. However, because Y-DNA is passed down essentially unchanged for several generations, our nearest common ancestor could be hundreds or even thousands of years removed from where we are today. And that's not the kind of thing that we ever hope to find a paper trail for. In 2016, 23andMe updated their website and their algorithms. And as part of this, they also changed the naming convention that they use for haplogroups to what is more commonly used throughout the genealogy and the genetics community. I became haplogroup R-P311, and my brother-in-law became haplogroup R-L51. Now, if we take a quick look at the haplogroup tree right here, we see that R-P311 is actually a descendant of R-L51. So if anything, now I'm even more distantly related from my brother-in-law than I was before. After several other male relatives of my family had tested, I had built a little bit of a curious tree, and you can see it now. I am the darker green slash tealish almost color, and that is haplogroup R-P311. You can see that my three brothers are all R-P311 as well, and my three sons are R-P311. My brother-in-law is R-L51, and where it gets interesting is my dad and my grandfather are both R-L51. What could be going on? First off, one might guess that maybe me and my brothers are all adopted. However, our autosomal DNA matches both my father and my mother's DNA. So we're not adopted. We're actually all descended from my mother and father. Second, maybe me and my brothers are the first in the R-P311 haplogroup. We're the founders of it. Except that's not how haplogroups usually work. Because haplogroups are formed with a new mutation, it's usually just one person that is the founder of that. And there's the pesky fact that R-P311 is documented by hundreds, if not thousands of people throughout the world already. So there's no way that we are the founders of that. So there must be some other explanation. To get to the bottom of this, we actually need to look at what tests we took and what they were looking at in those tests. Now, all of us tested at 23andMe. However, 23andMe has changed their chip over the years, and so each of the tests was not the same test. Starting with me, I tested with the version 3 chip. My grandfather, my father, and my brother-in-law all tested with the version 4 chip. My brothers and my kids all tested with the version 5 chip. So right off the bat, you can see the version 3 and the version 5 chip were all calling the same haplogroup, whereas the version 4 chip was calling a different haplogroup. Now, haplogroups are determined by the SNPs, And so we need to take a look at these SNPs that were tested in each one of these tests to see which one would be the most accurate. Now, first off, from this table right here, you can see that version 3 actually has the least amount of SNPs tested, especially when you consider all of the known calls. Version 4 has about 150 more SNPs than version 3, but the best case is actually version 5, which has almost three times as many SNPs as version 3 and more than twice as many SNPs as version 4. So based on this information alone, I would actually assume that version 5 is going to be the most accurate just because it has more SNPs. But haplogroups are really dependent on individual SNPs. And so the most important thing is not the number of SNPs, but the actual SNP that defines that haplogroup. For R-P311, there is a mutation from A to G at RS9785659. You don't have to remember that. Now, searching through the raw data on my version 3 file, I found that SNP is present, and it was called as that mutation. And so that's why it identified me as R-P311. Looking through the version 5 raw data for my brothers and my sons, that SNP is also present, and it does show that mutation. But when I look at the version 4 file for my brother-in-law and my dad and my grandfather, that SNP was not one of the SNPs that was tested. And so it defaults back to the parent SNP, which is the haplogroup that they are called out, R-L51. Based on that, I would expect if my father tested with 23andMe version 5, he would show up as haplogroup R-P311, the same as me, my brothers, and my sons. But the question then is, what about my brother-in-law? Well, since I don't have any information about his father or his son, we can only guess. And the only way to know for sure whether we actually share a haplogroup or whether we're different haplogroups is to have him tested again or to have his son tested. And now another word from our sponsor. We're excited to be attending the Family Roots Conference in St. George, Utah, and hope that you can join us there. They have classes about all aspects of genealogy. There's a vendor hall with lots of exhibits and things to do for all ages of the family. That is at the end of September. You can get all the details in the description below. Prices start at just $29. And there's activities available for the whole family. So check out the links in the description and join us at the end of September in St. George, Utah at the Family Roots Conference. Now, before I end, I want to throw another wrench into this mix of haplogroups. The ISOG website indicates that living DNA actually tests 22,000 SNPs on the Y chromosome. My living DNA test doesn't say I'm part of haplogroup R-P311, but that I'm part of haplogroup R-P312/R-Z220, which is actually, as you can see on this tree, a few more steps down the haplogroup tree, which would indicate that they're actually testing for some more SNPs, and they've found other terminal SNPs beyond what 23andMe has found. So if you have any questions about your haplogroup and the SNPs that are associated with it, put it in the comments below, and we'll try to answer it for you. Connect with us on Twitter at FH Fanatics or on Facebook, Family History Fanatics, where we can interact with you and respond to your comments.